Hello friends, I'm Monica. Welcome to Fun Gardening. Today we will talk about the propagation of Vinca plant. During monsoon, it's very easy to propagate Vinca plant by cutting. Very small cuttings, 2-inch to 3-inch long cuttings are enough to grow. And they grow, they root in 15 days to 20 days, and it is a very good season to grow these plants by cutting. So I'll show you how to take cutting. You can see I have so many colors of Vinca flowers. Look at the size of the flower. This is dark pink, or you can say magenta color flower, and this is dark pink. This is white color. These are all hybrid Vinca flower. Vinca plants, hybrid Vinca plants they grow bigger flowers than the normal desi variety, you can say. This is very dark color, not visible clearly in camera, but it is the darkest color I have. This is dark pink, and this is a very different color. It is magenta color, very bright pink color, purplish pink color, and very beautiful flower. And this is dark pink with some variegation in the center. So now we will take cutting. So I'll show you how to take cuttings from this plant. I'm taking cuttings. This branch is is looking leggy and little unhealthy, so I have taken this. Take 1, 2, or 3 inch long cutting, and cutting should have the growing point. Remove these flowers and buds so that our cutting does not spend its energy in the blooming of flower. So the second cutting I am taking, this one is very small cutting. This cutting, this is extra small. I'm not going to take this cutting. This cutting, I have taken these two cuttings, and I have already grown these cuttings. Earlier I made one video on cuttings on my Hindi channel. So these cuttings I have already grown, and they are doing well. You can grow these cuttings in any bigger pot you have, or if you want to grow them in separate pots, the potting soil should be very well drained. Take one part of soil and one part of sand. No need to add fertilizer when we grow cuttings. Or you can either you can take one part of soil or one part sand, or you can mix one part of coco peat and one part of sand. So that makes very well drained mixture for cuttings, and cuttings, they require very well drained mixture so that the roots can grow easily. So I am growing these cuttings in one of my containers. This is 20 inch container. Now apply some rooting hormone. This is rooting hormone. You can get this this rooting hormone from any agriculture shop. Apply rooting hormone in cutting, and then tap, and make a hole in the soil mixture and place the cutting gently in the hole and press the soil around, and same I'll do with this cutting. I'm applying rooting hormone. Tap to remove extra rooting hormone and place the cutting 1 inch or 1.5 inch portion. One inch is sufficient, but you can place 1.5 inch portion of cutting in the hole also and press it gently. Then give some water so that there should not be any air spaces left in the soil around the cutting. And these cuttings will, in rainy season, this is the best season to grow these cuttings. And in during rainy season, these cuttings root in 12 to 20 days, 15 to 20 days, and you can get a very beautiful flowers. And actually, cutting grown plants are the clones of the mother plants. And these plants give flowers exactly same as the mother plant. Whereas when you grow plants from the seeds of these hybrid plants, the seeds do not always produce same type of plants. So cutting is a better option for the hybrid plants to obtain, to propagate new plants. So friends, if you like my video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. Okay friends, bye.